Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the monthly reading for all zodiac signs. I know we're a little bit behind, but we've been extremely busy. Not only with the craziness that's going on worldwide, and family, making sure that family is good and safe, but it's just been a crazy, crazy past 3 months. So anyways, let's get into your reading. This is going to be for Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this month of May 2020. Okay, so in regards to your finances and business, you have the World card. Wow, beautiful card, Scorpio. All right, so in regards to your business and finances, the World card signifies the conclusion or ending of something. For some of you guys, especially those of you guys that have been in quarantine or have been considered non-essential and have been taking some time off, with the World card, that is quickly coming to an end, or perhaps there's going to be an opportunity that arises that is going to give you basically the stepping stones to move towards a new beginning. So that's definitely a good thing. For others of you, the World card could symbolize some type of travel in regards to your finances, in regards to business. Now, because of what's happening globally, I feel that this has more to do with the conclusion of isolation for some. Like I said, if you've been recently laid off or recently haven't been working because of what's going on, I definitely do see that ending coming. For some of you guys, it could represent like your business opening up again. For others, being called back to work, that type of energy. And the World card also signifies getting close to the conclusion or ending cycle of a strife that we've been currently going through. So this is definitely a positive, positive card to see. Now, in regards to your communication for this month of May, you have the Four of Swords. So the Four of Swords could signify, again, being in quarantine or not being completely social, not communicating as much. For some of you guys, it could even be like getting like friends texting you and communicating, or even your partner, and feeling a bit restrictive or feeling like, I just don't want to text right now, I'll text later, that type of energy. But again, with the World card, that could signify getting to the conclusion or ending cycle of feeling this way, feeling like a bit like you're kind of switched off, you're kind of not wanting to connect with anyone. But I definitely see that coming to a quick end. So I think that for the month of May, it could be the second week or third week of May where you feel like you're coming out of that funk. And I definitely think that I could totally relate to that, Scorpio, but you're definitely coming out of that funk of feeling like, it could be just, you know, the energy that we've all been experiencing. But I see you guys like getting this burst of energy and like starting to get back on being on the grind, or getting back to being like social, even if it's just communicating and texting, being more like checked in instead of checked out. So definitely good thing, Scorpio. All right. So the obstacle to overcome for this month is the Nine of Swords. So I see you guys coming out of anxiety, coming out of worries. Again, for some of you guys, it could have been worries in regards to money, in regards to finances. And I definitely see you guys coming out or getting out of that cycle, moving towards something new, something positive. I see a lot of strife, a lot of feeling like, even getting to the point of feeling like, why even try type of energy. But again, with the World card, that's definitely what you want to see, because this is basically their basically what they're saying here is that you're coming out of this funk where you felt stuck or you felt restless. There was a lot of worries, and that's finally coming to its conclusion. Okay. All right. So finally, in regards to love and romance, you have the Six of Cups. All right. So the Six of Cups in regards to love and romance could signify, really connecting on a very deeper level with your kids, with the family dynamic. For some of you guys, it could be because there was lack of like business or lack of like working, something that has to do with finances. Perhaps some of you guys were extreme like at home and dealing with like, you know, the children. If for those of you guys that are married, it could have been like you guys were extremely stressed out because of that. And I definitely see you guys going back to work. For others, I also see like someone in regards to love and romance, if there was some type of conclusion or some type of ending where you haven't been able to move on from this situation, the Six of Cups could represent having or starting to have open communication with a person that is directly connected to your past, especially if you've been waiting on this communication to happen. For some of you guys, it could be dealing with an ex-partner. For others of you, it could be a person that you haven't been with for quite a while, and out of nowhere, they communicate or communication opens up. And there's almost this feeling like you kind of knew deep down inside your heart that at some point this would happen. Doesn't necessarily speak about reconciliation, but I definitely do see communication opening up, and it is a person that's coming towards you that is from your past. So again, I feel that for some of you guys, you've been hoping to hear about this. For others of you, it may not fall on welcoming ears. If this was a toxic type of energy or a toxic person, I would highly encourage you to not, you know, embrace this new beginning. But if this was something that, especially if it was a relationship that ended without having a specific, like having no closure, I think that this is really going to help you. So embrace that change, okay? Now, finally, Spirit's advice, the Sun card. So what they're telling you here, Scorpio, is let your worries melt away. Understand that, yes, we're all struggling and we've all been going through emotional turmoil with everything, not just with love, not just with finances, but with every single aspect in our life. And if this is something that you've been dealing with, know and understand that Spirit is here to tell you, you are protected, Scorpio. You are protected and you're being guided. There is finally a veil that is being lifted for some of you guys. It could have been even experiencing like when it comes to relationships, perhaps you haven't been able to manifest something that is long-term. And with the Sun card, this is Spirit telling you that you're coming into this new cycle with the World card, the concluding of strife and difficulty and being able to embrace a new beginning that comes not only with blessings, but with a deeper connection with someone that is of a soul family. Meaning for those of you guys that are currently single, and like I said, you found it very difficult to connect with someone, I definitely do see a new love coming towards you. The Sun card is always joyous type of energy, but it also signifies partnership, and it is a blessing or a partnership that has been blessed to come through for you, okay? So I hope you guys enjoyed this reading. Like, share, and comment. I hope you guys do what you have to do to keep yourselves safe and sound, my lovelies, and we'll see each other soon. Till then, I'll see you guys soon. Bye.